click the subscribe button to show us your support and also the bell button to get notified if a new video were to come out. Hey guys, and it's Dewar the Clever here, and welcome back. Today, we'll be continuing our Canadian President Simulator. In the last episode, we have actually taken over most of Scandinavia. By this episode, we'll have to rebuild our army, so we won't really be that aggressive. Instead, we'll go ahead and build up our national support and also our army. We'll now head over to the healthcare tab and construct more of those buildings. As in a couple of past episodes, we have found that it actually did increase our popularity whenever a construction was completed, and the health resort giving the most popularity. And as you can see, we have spent all our cash on healthcare, so now we'll fast forward the time and we'll be back when the popularity gets increased. And we're back, and as you guys can see, our popularity has increased out of the danger zone, so we can use our income that we have also balanced up to go ahead and purchase some new equipment for our army. We'll leave the healthcare buildings to continue with their construction at the back. So we have about 3 million to spend on our military, and we'll be using up most of it at least, or not all of it. So we're gonna focus heavily on the armed forces and our air force, as the navy for now is not really a priority, as the Scandinavian countries are not really that, I guess, powerful in their navy, and we already have quite a sizable navy, although we do not have an aircraft carrier, so we might build just one of the aircraft carrier for our navy. The rest of our income would be focused on our armed forces and our air force. And so while I was selecting the armed forces to build, I noticed there was a blue and white arrow at the top, and so I went to click on it under sight rifle, thinking that it might increase by 1,000 or so, and to my surprise, it increased by everything. So now our entire income has been diverted to the assault rifles, and we're unable to build other stuff, so this was set us back by a bit, but not to worry, our income is pretty high, so we'll do fine. We'll just have to pass the time. Fast forward a few months, and we have gained back some of our money, so now we'll go ahead and continue with our building of the other armed forces, but we'll take note not to click the arrow at the top, as it will just drain up all our income on that particular weapon. And we're back, and we have drained all our income building our armies, again focusing heavily on the armed forces and the air force. So we have built a couple of aircrafts, about 107 tanks, as tanks are particularly useful in this game, and the rest a couple of each, so it should be under production right now, and we'll be back when it's almost completed also. And while our army is building up, we can take a look at our healthcare again, and we are, in terms of healthcare, we are in 29th place in the world, so that won't do it. And also our healthcare is not currently building any of the buildings, so that also would not do. We'll have to start right now to construct more of our healthcare to boost our popularity. And with that, we are currently constructing more healthcare buildings, and you guys might ask, why am I building so many at a time, taking up to even 1,000 over days? But then we can use our income right now to build as many as we can, and we will not need to come back to this tab for some time, and we can focus on the other tabs, as this healthcare will be building in the background, so we won't need to keep coming back to this page and adding on buildings. And one more thing to take note of is that our population has increased by roughly 2 million, but then our income has not increased at all, which means additional 2 million people are in our country living but not working, and in terms that means that we are not getting any of the income, which we will not do in our country. Now we have to increase the retirement age so that our income will also increase, but our popularity will fall, but our healthcare will take care of that, so it will be stable again. So let's slowly increase the retirement age for the genders to 69. And as you guys can see, our popularity has dropped, but then our income has increased, so that's cool. We can go ahead and increase the retirement age by one more year. Our income has again increased and our popularity has once again dropped, but not to worry, our healthcare will take care of that. And now we'll be increasing our army size, and this goes out to the commenter Kingdom of Montenegro. In the comment section below, in the previous video, he actually explained about how we can increase our army size, and it's under the executive tab under the Ministry of Defense. You can see that there's the number of employees, so by increasing it, it actually increases our army. So thanks again to Kingdom of Montenegro. But right now, since we have an increase of income, we can go ahead and assign a new Minister of Defense first. We'll be assigning the second best, which is the Ministry Leader, Colonel General Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary. Yes, it will cost us 2,600 a day, but we have more than enough to provide for him, and he will increase our attack and defense by 10%. There's the best one, which is the General of the Army, but then he's a premium, which means you have to pay for him, and he will increase the attack and defense of a country by 100%, but since we do not want to pay for any generals, we'll go ahead with the second best. And we'll also be increasing our number of employees so that our army manpower can also increase. And with our booming population, it's not hard to find new recruits for our army. And as you guys can see, I have actually increased the army size to 123,500, and our income has also significantly dropped. But not to worry, as our army is now significantly bigger, which means more army to fight in the wars that will induce in the future. And we have fast forwarded again a few months, and we have stockpiled even more money. So now we are at the management tab for the construction. So we will have to construct some new bases, I guess, but not any satellites. It will cost at least 10 million to build one satellite, and we don't have that kind of money. So we'll instead go ahead and maybe increase our naval base and our communication center. We will also be doing the drills for all of the army right now. And since we have done the drills and building of the naval and communication centers, our income has once again dropped to just slightly above 11,000, which isn't that nice, but our popularity will rise up after our healthcare centers have been built, and we'll again maybe increase the retirement age or decrease their basic wage. And of course, in order to take over the world, we will need to produce our own weapons and not rely on other countries. After all, which other country will want to supply weapons to a potential hostile country? So we have to go ahead and build our own weapons. And as you guys can see, our military production, for example, our truck production is about 20,000, and our consuming rate is at 26,000, so that is not good. We'll have to increase all our production to outproduce our consuming, so that in the event of a war, we will not need to rely on other countries. We can support our own self. And with that, we have built a couple of each for pistol, assault, ATGM, manpads, armored car, armor, aircraft, and tanks. We do not have enough money though to build the fighter aircraft, but that's alright. And with that, we'll be stopping here for today. And do tell me in the comment section below of what you guys think of this video and what you guys want to see in the future and how I could improve on this video. And if you guys got any tips, do tell me in the comment section below, as Kingdom of Montenegro has already given a tip which is quite useful. So go ahead and give all your tips down in the comment section below and I'll respond to it. And if it is good enough, I will say it in the video itself. And don't forget to like, subscribe and share, as that actually helps me out a lot. And that also tells me that you guys like this type of video series and I'll also keep producing it. And of course, as usual, thanks for watching and goodbye.